Here x of n equals to cos pi n by 4 plus cos pi n. With an input to LTI system with impulse response delta of n plus delta of n minus 1. Then the corresponding output sequence y of n is. Yeah, what is the output sequence? When input is x of n, what is the output of this? X of n is my input. And I want to look into my output. See my h of n, LTI system. Delta of n plus delta of n minus 1. Then what is the output? Yeah, what is the output y of n? The output is a convolution, right? Linear convolution. That will be x of n plus x of n minus 1. X of n plus x of n minus 1. Here this is my x of n. I have x of n as it is, and x of n minus 1 means replacing n with n minus 1 in this expression. Then what we are going to get? Okay, is it okay or any mistake is there in this answer? Cos pi n by 4 plus cos pi n. This is my x of n. Plus x of n minus 1 means cos pi into n minus 1 divided by 4 plus cos pi into n minus 1. Cos pi into n minus 1. This one corresponds to how much? Are they cancelling out these two? Is it true or false? These two gets cancelled out. Is it true or is there any mistake?
One and minus one, the results.
Okay. One and minus one.
Okay, if for example, pi n results one. Pi n minus 1 results minus 1, right?
Yeah, opposite, right? Yeah, that's fine.
Yes, sir.
Well, suppose for n even, this will be 1. For n even, this will be minus 1. For n odd, this is minus 1. And this will be plus 1 for n odd. They are getting cancelled out, right? You are getting cancelled out. And this is the leftover thing, finally. Consider the following system, y of n equals to 2 y of n minus 1 plus 0.2 x of n. This is some recursive expression, right? Output is a function of past output also, along with present input. Where x of n and y of n are the input and output sequences. And find the impulse response of the stable LTI system. Stable system. It's mentioned like stable system. Y of n equals to 2 y of n minus 1. Two y of n minus one plus 0.2 x of n plus 0.2 x of n implies that if I apply z transform both sides, y of z equals to 2 into z power minus 1 into y of z, 2 into z power minus 1 into y of z plus 0.2 into x of z. See, otherwise you can straight away apply this thing. That's also fine for me. Yeah, let me complete this first. Implies y of z by x of z equals to how much? If I take this side, 1 minus 2z power minus 1 into y of z. then y of z by x of z equals to, this is known as transfer function, equals to 0.2 divided by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 implies h of n equals to, I want a stable, stable system means mod z equal to 1 should be in ROC, should be part of ROC, right? Mod z equal to 1 should be part of ROC, a stable system. It should be part of ROC means my poly z equal to 2. It means my ROC should be mod z less than 2, right? That should be mod z less than 2 with this condition. If mod z greater than 2, this one will be part of my ROC, right? It means the sequence should be left-sided sequence. 0.2 is some constant into inverse transform for 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 when that is left-sided sequence is nothing but minus 2 power n into u of minus n minus 1. This is what my h of n. Otherwise, you can do in this way. Replace x of n with delta of n. Then the response I am going to get is h of something. This is my impulse response, right? When the input is delta of n. Now you can apply the transform for this. Otherwise, you can go in another way. DTFT also fine for me. If you want, you can do this with the help of DTFT. That's also fine. Instead of z, you can go with e power j omega. DTFT also, you can solve. There's no issue with that. Okay, consider the analog signal cos 2 pi f1 t plus cos 2 pi f2 t, where f1 is 1 kHz, f2 is 4 kHz. The signal is sampled with the following sampling rates and passed through ideal analog filter, low pass filter. The graph frequency is 5.5 kHz. And what are the corresponding frequency components that you can see at the output of analog low pass filter? Let me have these ones. Now to write that precisely, because I cannot ask you with gains, right? I just asked you to compute the frequencies. My sampling rate, okay, our sampling rate here is 10 kilo samples per second, for example. 10 kilo samples per second is my sampling rate. And f1 equals to 1 kHz, f2 equals to 4 kHz. F2 equals to 4 kHz. According to that sampling theorem, what is the Fourier transform for this? Sigma k equals to minus infinity plus infinity. Let me have this impulsive sampling t minus kts, where ts equals to 1 by fs. If I multiply this one with my signal x of t, analog signal x of t, the DTFT we are going to get is not DTFT, Fourier transform, continuous time Fourier transform we are going to get is convolution of Fourier transform for this and this. Finally, we ended up somewhere here, right? Some 2 pi by t, yeah, no need to worry about this constant. I just asked you frequencies, right? I'm proportional to either the same thing. A goes to minus infinity plus infinity. What should be this one? X of f minus k fs, right? Or I can say plus also okay for me. Instead of minus, anything is fine. That's what we are going to get. That x of f will repeat for every fs, right? For me, x of f corresponds to 1 kHz and 4 kHz, right? This is my x of f. 1k, at 1k I have one component, at 4k I have. By default, due to symmetry, negative side I will get, right? Minus 1k and minus 4k. This is my x of f in some constants. Yeah, forget about that constant. Now, this block will repeat for every fs according to this statement. I'll shift this right side by fs, left side by fs. After that, shift this block right side by 2fs, left side by 2fs, and so on. We have shift this right side by fs. Here, 10 kilo samples per second, right? 0 shifted to 10, plus 10, right? 10 k, 0 shifted to this. Minus 1 shifted to how much? Shift this right side by 10 k. Minus 1 k shifted to? Yeah, can you respond? Minus 1 k shifted to how much? Plus 10
9 k.
9, right? Yeah, this is 9 k. This will be 9 k. Minus 4 k shifted to 6 k. Plus 10 k, right? And 1 k shifted to 11 k. And this 4 k shifted to 14 k. Similarly, left side I'll get. I shift this left side by 10 k once again. Something like this only I'll get. Now I am applying low pass filter finally with a cutoff frequency of 5.5, analog low pass filter. Analog low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of 5.5 kHz means how much? Somewhere here, right? 5.5 kHz. By default symmetry, minus 5.5 k. It's an analog low pass filter. Now the frequency components I am going to get are 1k and 4k. 1k and 4k. For this case, that is fine. Now let's go to next one. Fs equals to 6k. Fs equals to 6k. Let me look into that once. Okay, fs equal to 6k means I'll have to shift this entire block right side by 6k. 0 shifted to 6k. 0 shifted to 6k. And minus 1 shifted to plus 6 means 5, right? This is 5k. Minus 4 shifted to minus 4 plus 6 means 2, right? 2k. Minus 4 plus 6k means 2k. And this 1k shifted to 1 plus 6 means 7. And this 4k shifted to 4 plus 6 means 10k. Okay, 10k we already have somewhere here, right? Like this we are ready. Similarly, you can redo this side also. Shift this entire block, this blue colored one, left side by 6k. And you can repeat the procedure by 12k, by 12k this side, and so on. Now, if you try to apply low pass filter, analog low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of 5.5 kHz, then what are the frequency components that we are going to get? Let's look into this. 1k after filtering operation, we are going to get 1k, 2k, 4k, and 5k. Total 4 frequency components we are getting after applying 5.5 kilo analog low pass filter. Due to aliasing effect. The aliasing effect, right? We are not satisfying that condition. Fs should be greater than or equal to fmax. Here fmax equals to 4k. At least 8 kilo samples per second we need to maintain, right? But sampling rate is 6k here in the second case. In the first case, there is no aliasing. We are able to get exactly the same thing. Second case, there is aliasing effect. That's why that's creating issues, right? Okay, let us consider a speech signal sampled at 10,000 samples per second. If you delay the sampled signal by 100 samples, then what is the equivalent delay in seconds? Yeah, how much? X of n minus 100 is nothing but equivalent to X of n minus 100 into TS. In a sub-seconds. It means that got delayed by NTS minus 100 TS, right? This is the delay we are going to produce. 100 samples delay means 100 TS delay. This much delay. 100 TS means 100 by FS. 100 into 1 by 10 power 4, 10,000, right? 10 power minus 2 means 10 milliseconds. This much delay. Okay, what are the gain and phase shift at the following digital frequencies? For the digital system with impulse response, h of n equals to 0.5 delta of n minus 0.5 delta of n minus 1. Gain and phase shift. Yes. That can be done with the help of DTFT, right? DTFT means let me consider this. This is my x of n. This is my impulse response of LTA system. This is my output y of n, which is linear convolution of x of n with h of n. If I do DTFT, the transfer function h of e power j omega, or frequency response of the system, LTA system, then my y of e power j omega is nothing but x of e power j omega into h of e power j omega, right? And it is given that h of n equals to 0.5 delta of n minus 0.5 delta of n minus 1. 1 by 2 into delta of n minus delta of n minus 1. And if I do DTFT, apply DTFT for this, 1 by 2 delta of n DTFT is 1. Delta of n minus 1 DTFT is e power minus j omega. Z transform means 1 plus z power minus 1. 1 minus z power minus 1. Z transform. DTFT is this, which is equals to 1 by 2. If I take e power minus j omega by 2 common, then this will become e power j omega by 2. Second one will become like e power minus j omega by 2. If you want to multiply, we are going to get this only. Now, my h of e power j omega equals to e power minus j omega by 2 into multiply and divide with j. Say 2j, because that looks similar to sine, right? E power j omega by 2 minus e power minus j omega by 2. Can someone answer me what is this? J means e power j pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 plus j sin pi by 2, right? What is this term?
Sin omega by 2.
Yes, this is sin omega by 2, right? This is my h of e power j omega. Now, I am asking you to compute the gain at omega equal to pi by 2. Gain and phase. Omega equals to pi by 2. At omega equals to pi by 2, h of e power j pi by 2 equals to replace omega with pi by 2. You see, e power minus j pi by 4, right? E power minus j pi by 4 into e power j pi by 2 means?
Plus pi by 4 will get.
Plus pi by 4, right? E power j pi by 4 into sine pi by 4. Sine pi by 4, right? Omega equals pi by 2. Sine pi by 4. This is what I am going to get. Now, if I compute magnitude of this one, mod h of e power j pi by 2 equals to magnitude of this is 1. Mod a b equals to mod a into mod b. Magnitude of this is 1. And magnitude of sine pi by 4 means 1 by root 2. Yeah, 1 by root 2 means roughly 0.7. This is root 2 by 2. Root 2 means 1.414 roughly. Divide by 2. It's roughly 0.7 approximately. Like that again, yeah. And phase. What about phase? Sine pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. This is positive quantity. If there is a minus sign, then e power j pi will come, right? Minus 1 means e power j pi. Pi phase shift. Negative sign. They don't need to sign for this. Phi gets smashed to pi by 4, that's it. 1 by root 2 into e power j pi by 4, r e power j theta, where theta equals pi by 4. 0.7 and pi by 4. And at omega equal to pi, at omega equals to pi, h of e power j pi equals to, h of e power j pi equals to, at omega equals to pi, right? E power minus j pi by 2 into e power j pi by 2. Both are getting cancelled out. Just sin pi by 2 is there. Sin pi by 2 means 1. H of e power j pi by 2 equals to 1 means it's nothing but 1 e power j 0. It's gain 1, phase 0. Consider y of n equals to x of n minus 0.2, x of n minus 1. Here x of n and y of n represents the input and output sequences of the system. Then what is the frequency response of the inverse system? Inverse system means y of n equals to x of n point 2 into x of n minus 1. See my system, I need to compute frequency response of the inverse system. Okay, first of all, if you apply DTFT for this one, DTFT both sides, y of e power j omega equals to x of e power j omega minus 0.2. What is the DTFT for this?
Minus j omega.
0.2 e power minus j omega into x of e power j omega. Otherwise, you can replace y with h, x with delta of n. That's also fine. DTFT for delta of n is 1. DTFT for h of n is h of e power j omega. Anything is fine. Implies h of e power j omega equals to y of e power j omega by x of e power j omega, which is equals to, yeah, which is equals to 1 minus 0.2. e power minus j omega. And then what should be the inverse system for this? Inverse system for this. 1 by h of e power j omega, right? This is my inverse system. Or if that is convolution, that should be delta of n, that impulse response. If I multiply this one with h of e power j omega, I will get 1, right? The inverse system is this. 1 by 1 minus 0.2 e power 1 j omega. See my inverse system. The impulse response, okay, this is the frequency response for my inverse system. Okay, let us consider x of n equals to cos pi n by 2 pass through a discrete time LTI system. The impulse response h of n as given follows. Then what is the response of the system? Yeah, what is the response of this system? H of n equals to 0.5 delta of n. Plus 0.5 delta of n minus 1. Okay, let me find DTFT for this, or frequency response for this one. If 1 by 2 delta of n, DTFT for delta of n is 1, DTFT for delta of n minus 1 is e power minus j omega. This will be 1 by 2 if I take e power minus j omega by 2 common. Then this will be e power j omega by 2 plus e power minus j omega by 2. This is some trick manipulation. This corresponds to cos, right? E power minus j omega by 2 into cos omega by 2. Now the question is, my input is cos pi n by 2. Input is cos pi n by 2. as omega n, where omega equal to pi by 2. Then the constant output I need to find. This will be multiplied with gain at pi by 2 and phase will be added at pi by 2, right? What is the gain at pi by 2? Mod h of e power j pi by 2 equals to omega equal to pi by 2. See, e power minus j pi by 4. See, magnitude, right? Mod of this is 1. This mod of this is 1. And mod of cos pi by 4. Omega equal to pi by 2, right?
1 by root 2.
This is 1 by root 2. It means 1 by root 2 into cos pi by 2 n and some phase will be added. That phase is at pi by 2. If I substitute pi by 2 here, then this will become pi by 4. Cos pi by 4 means 1 by root 2. And 1 by root 2 into e power minus j pi by 4. E power minus j pi by 4. It means phase is minus pi by 4. Is a phase. In this way, we can do. If you want blindly, you can do this also. Just do this. But this might be a bit lengthy. Do convolution of x of n with this. X of n convolution with this one is 0.5 x of n plus 0.5 x of n minus 1. It means 0.5 x of n means 0.5 into pi by 2 n plus 0.5 x of n minus 1 means cos pi by 2 into n minus 1. And try to simplify this. Expand cos a minus b equals to cos a cos b plus n a sin b. And if you do simplification, you are going to end up here only. That's your wish. Whichever you are comfortable, in that way you can do. What is the DTFT for x of n equals to 0.5 whole power n minus 7 into e of n minus 4? 0.5 whole power n minus 7 into u of n minus 4. And let us go to the well-known fact. Well-known fact is, I know DTFT for 0.5 whole power n u of n. Otherwise, you can apply simply sigma x of n into e power minus j omega n. And you can simplify that. That's the thing you can do if you want. Otherwise, you can apply properties.
We can also do by keeping n in the exponential of 0.5. N plus 3, n minus 3. Plus yes. 3 minus 3, sir.
Yeah, that's good thing. Yeah, if you want, you can do like this. 0.5. 4 to the power of n minus 4 into u of n minus 4. The leftover thing is 0.5 whole power minus 3, right?
Yes, sir.
You are going to end up with this. This is 1 by 2 whole power minus 3. It's nothing but
8.
2 cube, right? 8. Is it 2 cube? 1 by 2 whole power minus 3. 1 by 2 means 2 power minus 1. Yeah. Okay, the well-known fact for me is, I know the DTFT for this. What is the DTFT for this? 1 by 1 minus 0.5 into e power minus j omega, right? This is the DTFT for that. Now if I do delay operation, delay by 4 units. I know DTFT for x of n minus 4 is e power minus j 4 omega into x of e power j omega, right? The trick I know. Now I can do the same thing, right? I can apply the same trick here. U of n minus 4 leads to e power minus j 4 omega divided by 1 minus 0.5 e power minus j omega is into 1 by this one. I got this finally. And the leftover thing is into 8 is there, right? Into 8 I need to both sides. This is my final answer. Okay, let us consider a digital signal x r n equals cos omega n, where omega is pi by 4 radians per sample. Let us consider x r n passed through an ideal delay system with propagation delay of 3 samples. 3 samples delay means 3 ts. Okay, then what is the phase shift introduced by the channel to our signal? Cos omega n. This is my input and delayed by 3 samples, right? X of n minus 3 equals to cos omega into n minus 3, which is nothing but cos omega n minus 3 omega. Cos of omega means pi by 4 in our example. Yeah. See, pi by 4 n minus 3 pi by 4. Even this is a phase introduced, right? 2 my cos pi by 4. This is a phase minus 3 pi by 4. Consider the following system y of n equals to 0.2 y of n minus 1 plus 2 into x of n, where x of n and y of n are the input and output sequences, and find the causal impulse response of the system. Causal impulse response of the system. That should be causal. Y of n equals to 0.2 y of n minus 1. Find y of n minus 1 plus 2 x of n. I can simply apply DTFT both sides. Otherwise, Z transform also okay, right? Now you are comfortable with Z transforms. We have Z equals to 0.2. This will be Z power minus 1 into Y of Z plus 2 X of Z. Implies H of Z equals to Y of Z by X of Z, which is equals to, if I take this side, 1 minus something, right? And 2 by 1 minus 0.2 Z power minus 1. I am expecting H of N to be a causal system. Causal system means mod Z. Yeah, what should be that one? Causal system means left-sided or right-sided? Right-sided sequence. That should be right-sided, right? Otherwise, you can try with the DTFT. That's also fine. Equals to 2 into 0.2 whole power n into u of n. This is causal, right? For n less than 0, this is 0. This is a causal system. That's what we are expecting here. See, if I want non-causal system, then what is the equivalent non-causal system for this? If I gave you this and I asked you to compute non-causal system, this will be 2 into 0.2 whole power n minus of this into u of minus n minus 1, where mod z less than 0.2, here mod z greater than 0.2. This is non-causal. This is non-causal. If I ask you to compute non-causal, this is non-causal. And this is a causal one. Which of the following are representing the impulse response of a stable LDA system? Stable LDA system means that should be absolutely summable. Absolutely summable means, let me consider these examples. Point to whole power n, u of minus n minus 1. If I do this one, this is equal to 0 for what? This is equal to 0 for n greater than or equal to 0. This is equals to 1. This part is equal to 1 only when n less than 0. Otherwise, this is equals to 0. It means n equal to minus infinity to minus 1, 0.2 whole to the power of n, right? See, what I am computing is sigma n equals minus infinity plus infinity. I have to prove that this is absolutely summable. If this is absolutely summable, then I can say stable system, otherwise unstable system, if this happens. That's what I am doing here. Is it infinity or less than infinity, this value? Okay, can I write like this? 1 to infinity and pi into whole power minus n, are they equal? The two things. Oh yeah, if you have doubt, what you can do is you can simply expand this. Let me go this way. For n equal to minus 1, pi into whole power minus 1. Pi into whole power minus 1, 1 means 1 by pi into. Plus for n equals to minus 2, pi into whole square means pi into whole power minus 2 means this one. For n equal to minus 3, 1 by 0.2 whole cube plus and so on. What about 1 by 0.2? Is it greater than 1 or less than 1? Greater than 1, right?
Yes, sir.
Now this will diverge. Equal to infinity, we are going to get. It's infinite summation, right? It's increasing. Equal to infinity. This diverging. This is unstable system. Okay, what about pi into whole power n u of n? Is it stable or unstable? 0 to infinity, pi into whole power n, inherently. This mod h of n, if I do that. N equal to 0 means 1, plus pi into, plus pi into whole square, plus and so on. So a by 1 minus r, right? A by 1 minus r is 0.8. Plus infinity. It's a stable system. It's stable. Okay, then what about other way? 2 power n u of n. Is it stable system? 1 plus 2 plus 2 square plus and so on. Is it stable?
No system.
Infinite, right? It's unstable system. Unstable system. Then what about minus 2 power n u of minus n minus 1? For n equal to minus 1, this is 1 by 2, right? So 1 by 2. For n equals to minus 2, 1 by 2 whole square. 2 power minus 2 means 1 by 2 whole square. Plus and so on. Minus of, okay, absolute value, right? Absolute value means, I can remove this, no issue. A by 1 minus r, 1 by 2 divided by 1 minus 1 by 2. This equals to 1, right? Which is less than infinity. This stable system, but this is non-causal. The causal, but unstable. This is a causal system, and also stable system. See, the same thing will work out here also, u of minus n. See, and no need to worry about this. U of minus n means, this is equal to 1 for all what? For all n less than or equal to 0. It will start with n equal to 0, right? And it will go till minus infinity. It means, 2 power 0 plus 2 power minus 1 plus 2 power minus 2 plus and so on. It's still finite. finite, right? It's stable. Okay, let us consider an input sequence x of n greater than 0 for n equal to 1 to 3, and it is 0 for other values of n, which is passed through an LTI system with impulse response h of n greater than 0, positive greater than 0, it means for n equal to 0, 1, 2, and it is 0 for other values of n. Then for what values of n, the output sequence y of n will be non-zero. Yeah, how to do this? And another one is 0, 1, 2, right? So lower limit, upper limit, lower limit and upper limit. What will happen after convolution? What is the length after convolution? Convolution, after convolution, what is the length? This length is 3, right? N1 plus N2, 3 plus 3, minus 1, 5 after convolution. Now what is the lower limit here? Sum of lower limits, right? After convolution, sum of lower limit means 0 plus 1, 1. Sum of upper limits means 5, right? 3 plus 2 is 5. And then the indices, non-zero indices are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This length getting matched to this, right? Yeah, the indices where that is non-zero. Yeah, can you prove this? I will give you the hint. Due to this property, this is non-zero. You can take some example. For example, x of 1 equals to 1, x of 2 equals to some 1, x of 3 equal to 1. Everything is above 0, right? And consider h of 0 equal to 1, h of 1 equal to 1, h of 2 equal to 1. And do convolution, there won't be any cancellation because everyone is positive here and there, right? There won't be any cancellation at all. Simply, we are going to get lower limit sum plus upper limit sum. You can do convolution cross check. This is a lower index we are going to get. This is the upper index we are going to get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. If the number of quantization levels used are 128, then how many bits per sample used in the process of encoding? Yeah, how to do this?
2 to the power of n.
Yes, 2 power n equals to 128, right? It means log 128 base 2. Log 2 to the power of 8. 2 power 10 means 1024. 2 power 9 means 512. 2 power 8 means 256, right? This is 2 power 7. 2 power 7 means 128 base 2. Equals to 7 log 2 base 2. 7 into 1. This is 7, right? 2 power 7 equals to 128. Yeah. Let x of n, y of n be the input and output sequences of a discrete system. Then which of the following is an LTI system? Okay, why this is not LTI system? First one. Y of n equal to x of n whole square.
Non-linear.
This is non-linear, right? This is non-linear. Yeah, what about y of n equal to x of 5n? This is linear. This is linear. But what is the problem?
Time varying.
This is time varying system as well. Yeah, I gave some example of x of 2n, right? Similarly, this will work out. And what about this one? What is the issue with this?
Non-linear.
This is non-linear, right? Due to this factor, minus 3 is there, right? Minus 3 is not there, this will be linear. That means none of them is an LTI system. Okay, which of the following is are true regarding the accumulator system that we discussed in our class? Equilibrium system means h of n equal to u of n, right? Impulse response we got. This is an IIR system, infinite impulse response system. Because u of infinity also 1, u of 0 also 1, right? The length of this impulse response is infinite duration. It's an IIR system. It is an unstable system because it is not absolutely summable. If we add them, sigma mod h of n, we are going to get infinity. This is unstable system. Okay, match the following units. This is regarding units and dimensions. Digital frequency omega means radians per sample. Okay, let me clarify this once again. Let me consider analog signal cos 2 pi ft. Cos theta. Theta is in, what are the units of theta? Radians. Theta means radians. This whole thing inside this. This whole thing should be in radians. Then what are the units of omega? Omega t will be in radians. Then what about omega?
Radians per second.
Radians per second, right? Radians per second. Because omega equal this divided by t, right? T means in seconds. And what about this one? It means 2 pi f corresponds to radians per second. Then what about f?
Hertz or seconds.
Yeah, hertz or second inverse, right? Per second or hertz. And one more thing is, fs is the sampling rate. Sampling rate. Then what should be this one? Samples per second, number of samples per second, right? And one more thing, digital frequency we have seen. 2 pi f by fs. Cos omega n, right? Where this is in radians. This whole thing inside this implies omega in the sample index, right? Radians per sample. Radians per sample. Yes, this should be, what should be this answer?
Radian per second.
Okay, radians per second, right? Okay. Consider analog signal x of t equals to cos 2 pi f 1 t minus sin 2 pi f 2 t plus cos. Okay, something is given with four frequencies f 1, f 2, f 3, f 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 kilohertz. And fs is 10,000 samples per second. Okay, is it undersampling, oversampling? Is it okay? Is there any aliasing effect? Highest frequency we have is 4 kilohertz and sampling rate is 10,000 samples per second. Is it okay? Is there any aliasing effect? Fs greater than 2 fm, right? Here 2 fm is 8 kilo samples per second. So above that, there is no aliasing effect. It passes through an ideal digital bandpass filter with bandpass cutoff frequencies 0.3 pi and 0.5 pi. After that, it is passed through analog low pass filter with cutoff frequency 5 kHz. Then what are the frequency components at the output? 1, 2, 3, 4 we are having, right? 1 kilohertz, 2 kilohertz, 3 kilohertz, and 4 kilohertz. These are our frequency components. And the sampling rate is 10 kilo samples per second. And then what is the equivalent digital frequencies for them? 2 pi f by fs. These are my frequencies. Implies, what is the equivalent digital frequency for 1 kilo? F by 10 k. 1 k by 10 k means, is it 2 pi by 10? 2 pi by 10 means 0.2 pi, right? What about this second one? Into 2, right? just into 2 and 4 pi. Whatever this, just into 3 for this, right? 2 pi into 3k divided by 10k, 0.6 pi. And this is just 4 times of this first, right? 0.8 pi. Because it's just a linearity. I'm just doing this multiplication, that's it. Here the given equivalent digital frequency is for me. Now I am passing this through a band pass filter, digital band pass filter with these cutoff frequencies, 0.3 pi, 0.5 pi. Ideal. Let me consider 0 to pi, this positive side. By default, minus pi side, negative side, it will replicate. There is no issue with that due to symmetry. This is my band pass filter given. This is a stop band, this is a pass band. Now, what are the components we are going to expect from this? These are my input signal frequencies to this digital filter. And what are the outputs? 0.3 to 0.5 band pass, right? 0.4 is in between. 0.6 is outside of this. Only this one, right? 0.4 pi is the only output we are going to get. Now, this is passed through analog low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of 5 kHz. Then what is the output we are going to get? Yeah, what is the output?
2 kilo.
Yes, 2 kilohertz, right? Because, see, FS equals to 10k. I am using deconstruction filter finally. The graph frequency of FS by 2. I'll get back to my actual signal, right? Because 0.4 pi corresponds to 2k. I'll get back to that. This is 2 kilohertz. Okay, which are the following is are true regarding the following system? Y of n equals to x of n minus 0.2 into x of n minus 1. Here, x of n and y of n represents the input and output sequences of the system. Y of n equals to x of n minus 0.2 x of n minus 1. Minus 0.2 x of n minus 1. What is given? Inverse system. Okay, is it an FIR system or IR system? Which of n equals to delta of n minus 0.2 into delta of n minus 1. The length of this one is just 2, right? 2 samples. N equal to 0 and n equal to 1. Just 2 samples. Length is 2. This is FIR system. What about inverse system? What is the inverse system for this? Yeah, first of all, let me tell what is H of Z for this? The transform for delta of n is 1. For this, otherwise you can go for DTFT, that's also fine. 0.2 z power minus 1. And inverse system transfer function is this, 1 by h of z. 1 by 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 1. If I consider mod z greater than 0.2, where this corresponds to causal and stable system. When I think about causal and stable system, I can go with this, right? Implies H inverse of N equals to 0.2 whole power N into U of N. Is it FIR or IR system, this one?
IIR.
IIR system, right? Infinite impulse response system. Because this is going till n equal to my infinite index, right? Inverse system is an IR system. Okay, we had done with this.